Good morning. Yesterday I have just started linear equation. Today I will continue with some work, conditions and modulus as well. Suppose if I get an expression like this, x minus 1 into x plus 2 into x minus 3 by 4 minus x into x plus 5. Greater than equals to 0. So this expression if I will get it, and they will be asking for the solution here. In previous questions, what we are actually doing, we are trying to get into factors in one side j. Already it is given here. So just I have to check whether all the x coefficients are positive or not. There is positive, there is positive, there is positive. Here it is negative. Here the x coefficient is negative, so multiply minus to both the side. That becomes x minus 1, x plus 2, x minus 3 by x minus 4 into x plus 1 is less than or equal to 0. Then go to the number line. Go to the number line. Equate each of the factors to 0, and the least value is minus 2. Then minus 1, then 1, then 3, then 4. Alright? Now, it is less than or equal to 0. Less than or equal to 0 means the values, the points where the factors which are having the points x is equal to 1, minus 2, and 3 will be closed. 1 closed, minus 2 closed. And 3 also closed. And rest is to are open. Because already yesterday I have told you, yesterday what I have told you, these values cannot be equal to 0. X cannot be equal to 4, x cannot be equal to minus 1. So at minus 1 and 4 it can open it. Now all the x coefficients are positive, so this is positive. Negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Suppose you will not multiply minus sign here. You will not multiply minus sign here. You can go with minus, plus, minus, plus. Alright? Now, what is my answer? My answer is less than is equal to 0. Negative portion. So, I will hold to this negative portion. So, my answer will be x belongs to minus infinity to minus 2. Closed. Union. Minus 1 to 1 closed, open interval, closed interval, union, closed interval 2 to 4 open is my solution. Alright, let me change the next question we are finding. That means you can see that the value is minus 2 and 1, they are closed, 3 is also in the numerator, that is also closed. Then we have considered negative because this is less than equals to 0, so negative we have considered this value and this value. So then if I get a question like this, x minus 1 whole square, x plus 2 whole cube, x minus 3 by x plus 4 into x minus 2 cube greater than or equals to 0. Consider this one as a square as well. Alright? Now, what happens here? We can see that the factors are having even power and odd power here. The factors are having even power and odd power. This power is even here, this is odd, this is even, this is odd. I can also this one as 4 also, no problem. I can take this one as 4, 6, 8. Now go to number line. Go to number line. Equate all factors to 0. The least value is minus 4. Then minus 2. Then use 1. 2, 3. But the general constant I gave you, the values which are in the denominator will have open interval, the points minus 4, 1 and 2 also open. These are closed. Alright. Now if I go with the old concept, try to understand now. If I go with the old concept, means all its coefficients are positive here, positive. This becomes positive, negative. I have to go with the answer positive, so I go with this part, this portion. Let's check the answer. That means the answer is supposed to be, try to understand, x belongs to minus 4 to minus 2, union 1 to 2, union 3 to infinity. This is supposed to be the answer. Let us check it out. Let's consider the value between 3 to infinity. Let's consider the value between 3 to infinity. 4 minus 1 positive, 4 plus 2 positive, 4 minus 3 positive, 4 plus 2 positive, 4 minus 3. This is correct. Take a value between 2 to 3. 2.5 minus 1 positive, 2.5 plus 2 positive, 2.5 minus 3 negative. So numerator is negative. 2.5 plus 4 positive, 2.5 minus 2 positive. So this is negative by positive, negative. This is correct. Then take a value between 1 to 2. Take a value between 1 to 2. 1.5 positive, positive, negative. 1.5 I am taking negative because 1.5 minus 2 negative. 1.5 plus 4 positive, power is also 4. 1.5 minus 2. 1.5 minus 2 negative, whole cube is negative. So negative, this also gives you negative. So negative, positive in this interval. This is correct now. This one is correct. This is also correct. Let's take a value between 1 and minus 2. Let's take a value between 1 and minus 0. 0 will take 0 minus 1, minus 1 whole square positive. 0 plus 2 whole cube positive. 0 minus 3 negative. Remember, it is negative. 0 plus 4 whole to the power 4 positive. 0 minus 2, minus 2 whole cube negative. Negative, what it gives you? Positive. But negative, what it gives you? Positive. That means in this number line there is a mistake. That means this has to be positive. So this is wrong. This has to be positive. Let us consider the value between minus 2 and minus 4. Minus 3, minus 1, whole square positive. Minus 3 plus 2, minus 1 whole cube, that is negative. Minus 3, minus 6, negative. Minus 3 plus 4, positive. Minus 3, minus 2, minus 5, whole cube, negative. 3 negative, so outcome will be negative. In between this also, I am getting a wrong value. But it gives me negative. But it gives me negative. Alright? That means this is negative. Let's take this one also. This one also, let us check it out. Take it. Value between this minus 5, positive. Minus 5 plus 2, minus 3, negative. This is also positive. This is also negative. Negative. It has to be negative. So this is correct. Now two intervals I got wrong. These two intervals are wrong. So what is the correct one? Let us see. Minus infinity. 2, 3. This is positive. This is negative. 1, minus 2. This is whole positive now. You can say this is whole positive. From 2 to minus 2, it is whole positive. This is positive, this is also positive. And these two whole negative. minus 2, minus 4, minus infinity. This whole is negative. Why this is become like this? Because the reason is, these are even power factors. These are even power factors. So even power factors are either they are equal to 0 at that point or they are positive. So what we can do now? We'll go for it. If I draw the number line on the positive negative, we can see now what I get the answer. Greater than equals to 0. So greater than equal to 0, which is my answer now? My answer is this part and this part. And what the interval? What is minus 2? Minus 2 close interval. And 2 open interval. 3 close interval. Alright, that means I must write down the answer like this. I need a positive answer. What should be the answer? The student will write down like this. X belongs to minus 2 to 2 union P to infinity. See, again there is a problem. This answer is wrong. Already I know this is wrong now. This answer is gone out of the picture. Okay? So, what are the denominator values here? Minus 4. Denominator values are minus 4 and 2. Denominator values are minus 4 and 2. Minus 4 is not lying between these two. Minus 4 is not coming under this one. And minus 1 is not coming to this one. Okay? But what is the numerator even factor? What is the even power factor that we have to look for? Even power factors are x is equal to 1 and x is equal to minus 4. The values are x equal to 1 and x equal to minus 4. Is 1 is coming between this? Yes, it is coming between this. Right? It is coming between this. And this is my correct answer. This is my correct answer. This answer is correct. For the same question, the condition would have been greater than 0. For the same equation, the condition would have been greater than 0. Suppose, only greater than 0. Then, what would be my answer? X belongs to, all the intervals will be open. All the intervals will be open. For that case, all the intervals will be open, only greater than 0. X belongs to minus 2 to 2 union P to infinity minus 1. You can see there is a change in answer. What I have done here? Minus 1. Why I have written minus 1? Because that 1 point comes in between minus 2 to 2. And if I replace that value here, if I consider, because here it is coming. And if I take that value here, then replace it here. Suppose I replace it here, this factor becomes 0. The whole terms become 0. Because there is an answer equal to 0. So I can consider that part here. But I cannot consider that part here. Because I need greater than 0. This solution is for greater than 0. Greater than 0 means it cannot be equal to 0. So if I take x equal to 1, which comes in between this, so if I substitute that value in this factor, this becomes 0. So I have to neglect it. I have to remove it. So what I did? I have removed the answer 1. Alright? Suppose, now the same question, which way I can do? If instead of doing this much, I'll tell you something little bit small. Suppose the question is greater than or equals to 0. Initially what you do, you avoid the even power factors from the number line. You avoid the even power factors from the number line. The points of the even power factors you remove from the number line. So, I will not consider minus 4, I will not consider 1. This square I am not going to consider. X equal to minus 4, x equal to 1, I will not consider. Then, minus 2, 2, 3. Denominator value is 2, close interval, this is open, this is open, minus 2. 2 is denominator value, no? This is open, this is close, 3, close, this is also close, okay. Now, all the exponents are neglected this, because you might be this way, I neglected it. Because these values are either equal to 0 or greater than 0. This either equal to 0, if I replace minus 4, it becomes 0. If I replace 1, it is equal to 0. So, I cannot replace minus 4, obviously, but I can replace 1 here. So, this is either equal to 0 or greater than 0 equals to 0. But this is always greater than 0. So, I am removing the positive terms. So, बट इट अपेयर ना एक्सट्रीम, ये पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव. बट इफ माय आंसर व्हाट आर टू होल्ड ग्रेटर दैन इक्वल्स टू 0, सो यू नीड टू होल्ड द पॉजिटिव पार्ट. सो x बिलोंग्स टू माइनस रूट ऑफ 2 यूनियन इनटू इनफिनिटी. डायरेक्टली आई कैन डू देन व्हाट आई नीड टू चेक is any value which is having a even power factor which is in the denominator is coming in between this denominator coming in between this because there is a sign equal to 0. When equal to 0 will be there, Patil check any denominator even power factors comes in between this. The denominator power factor is equal to minus 4. It is not coming in between this. Hence this is my final answer. But suppose the same question now. Same question, what I do? I'll make it less than 0. Less than 0. Go to number line again. Minus infinity. Infinity even. Neglect these two factors. Minus 2. 2. Positive, negative, in this case I have to hold the negative answer because less than 0, so this is, and this is, generally what I write up, x belongs to minus infinity to minus 2, close, union, 2 to 3, close, 2 to 3, close, alright, now what will happen here, if the answer is correct, I have to check. But what I told, less than 0 means I go to the negative, yes I have gone to the negative. Now what is the factors which are even power factors on the numerator and denominator? Because denominator is minus 4. Minus 4 is coming in between this. Yes, minus 4 is coming in between this. I cannot consider it because if I replace minus 4 here, because which is coming in between as a part of solution. Because x is less than minus 2, it is a part of solution. If I replace it here, that becomes 0 and the solution becomes undefined. So first I remove minus 4. Then let's come back to 1. X is equal to 1. I am not going to consider the odd power factors. X is equal to 1, 1 is not coming in between this. Suppose if 1 would have come in between this as well, so I have to remove 1 also. Because if I replace 1, it will be equal to 0. 1 minus 1 0. I can't get this one equal sign. So this is my final answer now. Minus 2 to minus 2, give me 2 to 3, minus 2. Correct? Next, we are going to start with modulus functions. Alright? Generally from your childhood, you are knowing what is the modulus function. Mod of 5, mod of minus 5, that is equals to 5. Why? Because when the number is negative, we used to multiply a minus sign to it to make it positive. That means what is the constant behind modulus? Mod x. Minus x when x is less than 0, x when x is greater than 0 is 0. That means if I go to number line, whenever you get a modulus, whether it is a linear modulus, quadratic modulus, or degree 3 modulus, any modulus, when it is equated to 0, that gives a partition values. What is that partition values? From where it differs with the sign. So x is equal to 0, so 0 is the partition value. And in the right hand side of 0, it is positive, greater than equals to 0, positive, the left hand side, it is negative. This side it is positive, this side it is negative. You may ask, sir, why are not given the equal sign here? Because any point on the number line, suppose a point is A, it has got three conditions, greater than, less than, equal to. Greater than, less than, equal to. So either this will contain equal sign or this will contain one of them. Both cannot be. So either you give it equal sign here or you can give it, no problem. Okay? Suppose instead of this modulus, another modulus is given to you. Modulus x minus 3. I'll write up, equate the modulus to 0. Equate the modulus to 0, that gives you x minus x is equal to 3. So 3 is the partition table. So whatever in the modulus, just write down that part and write down x is less than 3. That is what is trying to tell you to know. Just try to understand. Suppose I wrote here mod x minus x when x is less than 0, x when x is greater than or equal to 0. That means if the number is negative, suppose r instead of x is minus 5. That means x is less than 0, minus 5 is 6. So multiply your minus sign of your own to make it positive. Minus of minus, that shall become positive. Okay? So x is less than 3, minus x is minus 3, x minus 3, and x is greater than or equal to 3. Number line if I do, this is 3. Right hand side, x minus 3. Left hand side, minus x minus 3. Okay? Now, what kind of questions you will be getting in the examination? Which kind of question will be getting in the examination to solve modulus? As you are dealing with inequality, mod x is equal to less than equals to a one condition. Condition 2, modulus is greater than equals to a less than, or maybe they give you mod x is less than a, or they may give you mod x is greater than a. Only a difference is equal sign. So for this, what is the answer? X is less than or equals to a, greater than or equals to minus a. If I tell you by heart, you will tell sir how it's possible, just errors. Here also, x is less than a, greater than minus a. Here suppose if I write down x is greater than or equals to a and x is less than or equal to minus a. That means in the number line, there is a, either I go to this side, this is minus a, I'll go to this side. Close interval. For this, it is open interval a minus a. Right? I'll explain you, don't worry. Suppose mod x is less than or equal to a, this is the answer I wrote here. That means x is less than or equal to a, greater than or equal to minus a. How come? So, for example, if I'm taking mod x is less than or equals to 5. What value we must consider in place of x? Try to understand. What value we must consider instead of x, that the value is always less than or equals to 5? Kya value daloge x ke jagah jo hamesha 5 ya 5 se kam dega? To aap bologe sir, 5 bhi de sakte hain, 4 bhi de sakte hain, 3 bhi de sakte hain, 0 bhi de sakte hain, negative bhi de sakte hain minus 5 tak. Kyunki minus 5 ka modulus hai 5 ka dega. That means in the number line, your value starts from biggest value 5 and lowest value minus 5. That means you can range between this. So what my answer is, x is less than or equal to 5, greater than or equal to minus 5. That means x belongs to minus 5 to 5. Suppose if someone give you a question like this, minus 1 modulus is less than 7. Less than 7 or less than equals to 7? Only sign of equal, so condition will be same. So what I write down? I will follow this rule now. 2x minus 1 is less than 7, greater than minus 7. Next condition. So never remember the formula, try to understand logically the way I told it. Then add 1 to all the 3 sides, that becomes, if I add 1, because I have to make x free of everything. So first I remove 1 from here, add 1, minus 6, 2x less than 8. Then divide 2, the x coefficient is 2, divide 2, all the values, that is positive, so inequality will not change. Minus 3, x less than 4. So answer is x belongs to open interval minus 3 to 4. Number line also cancel, minus 3. Alright? Suppose mod x is greater than equals to a. What I wrote? X is greater than equals to a or x is less than equals to minus a. X is greater than equal to a, x is less than equal to minus a. How come? Let's go to the case. That means either a, I'll stand to this side, or I'll stand to this side. I'll do it. Suppose if I tell mod x is greater than is equals to 7, what value you must keep in the place of x, that the value should be greater than is equal to 7. आप x के जगह क्या रखिएगा जो value 7 से बड़ा होगा? अब बोलोगे सर 7 भी रख सकते हैं, कहीं इक्वल साइन है, सो इक्वल साइन नहीं रखता, 7 से बड़ा, 7.01, 7.001, keep on going, कहीं माइनस का भी तो मॉड्यूलस माइनस को भी तो नंबर को भी पॉजिटिव कर देगा, मींस माइनस 7 से कम भी कर सकते हैं. सपोज इफ देयर इज इक्वल साइन, आई कैन इन द नंबर लाइन आई कैन गो फ्रॉम 7 टू द राइट हैंड साइड बिकॉज आई नीड बिगर वैल्यू, माइनस 7 smaller bit because it converts to positive. So what is my answer here? Minus infinity to minus 7 union 7 to infinity. That's what I really gave you. Suppose if I get a question now, x minus 4 modulus is greater than equals to a. x minus 4 modulus is greater than equals to a. Now greater than equals to, what I do? 3x minus 4 greater than equals to a. Condition number 1. Condition number 2. 3x minus 4 less than equals to minus 8. Now solve it. 3x is greater than equals to 12. X is greater than equals to 4. The first part answer is 4 to infinity. Second part, 3x is less than equal to minus 4. X is less than equal to minus 4 by 3. X coefficient positive divided here. That means in the number line 4 to infinity minus 3 by 4 minus 4 by 3. So combine both, x belongs to minus infinity minus 4 by 3 union 4 by 3. Clear? Suppose if I get a question like this, mod x minus 2 by mod x plus 3 less than is equals to 2. Either I'll get this question in the examination or I'll get x minus 2 modulus by x plus 3 less than is equals to 2 or x minus 2 x plus 3 modulus less than is equal to 2. If you look at all the questions are same. If you look at them, all the questions are same. I can have a single modulus because both are the modulus. Double modulus is meaningless. So if these three questions are equal to this, alright. Now what I do? I'll consider this one as y. I'll consider this one as y. Just now I'll think this way. If y is less than or equal to 2, what will happen? Just now I gave you the theory, y is less than equal to 2, greater than modulus y. Means the value I consider as modulus y. So y is less than equal to 2, y is greater than equal to minus 2. This is the way I did. So what I do now? X minus 2 by x plus 3 less than equal to 2, greater than equals to minus 2. Now solve individually. Take this one equation, x minus 2 by x plus 3 greater than equal to minus 2, solve it. 2 x minus 2 by x plus 3 less than equal to 2, solve this one. You know how to solve it? X minus 2 by x plus 3 प्लस टू ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू जीरो, एक्स माइनस टू प्लस टू एक्स प्लस सिक्स बाय एक्स प्लस थ्री ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू जीरो, थ्री एक्स प्लस फोर बाय एक्स प्लस थ्री ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू जीरो. नाउ गो टू नंबर लाइन, नाउ गो टू नंबर लाइन. तो फैक्टर सर माइनस थ्री प्लेस वैल्यू माइनस फोर बाई थ्री ओपन इंटरवल हियर दिस इज क्लोज पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव माइनस इंफिनिटी इंफिनिटी एक्स बिलोंग्स टू माइनस इंफिनिटी टू माइनस थ्री यूनियन माइनस फोर बाई थ्री टू इंफिनिटी सॉल्यूशन नंबर वन. सेकेंड वन एक्स माइनस टू बाई एक्स प्लस थ्री माइनस टू लेस देन इक्वल टू जीरो एक्स माइनस टू माइनस टू एक्स माइनस एक्स बाय एक्स प्लस थ्री लेस देन इक्वल टू जीरो ओके दैट गिव्स यू नाउ माइनस सिक्स माइनस एट बाय एक्स प्लस थ्री लेस देन इक्वल टू जीरो मल्टीप्लाई माइनस साइन हियर टू रिमूव द नेगेटिव एक्स प्लस एट बाय एक्स प्लस थ्री ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू जीरो नेवर फॉरगेट टू चेंज द इनइक्वालिटी बाय मल्टीप्लाई माइनस दैट बिकम्स नाउ गुड नंबर लाइन माइनस एट माइनस थ्री माइनस एट इज द स्मॉलर वैल्यू माइनस थ्री इज द बिगर वैल्यू ऑल द एक्सपेक्टेशंस आर पॉजिटिव पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव होल्ड द पॉजिटिव देयर इज ओपन इंटरवल x belongs to minus infinity to minus a union minus b to infinity. Solution number 2. Here you got the first solution. Here you got the first solution. And there is the second solution. Alright? Combine that. This you have understood. Consider this one as y. Mod y is less than or equal to 2. Then I will go with the condition y is less than or equal to 2 greater than or equal to minus 2. Then instead of y I will replace the value x minus 2 x plus 3. Two equations I am getting, two inequalities. First one, this greater than or equal to minus 2. I solved it, I got this answer. And second one, I solved it, I got this answer. Then both the answers you combine. Okay? Fine. So for today this is sufficient. Next class I am going on some difficult questions. Thank you.